Hello students, welcome to our YouTube channel all about baking and making. In the previous video, we have discussed the applications of inductive effect. Today, our class will be on mesomeric effect. So let us consider a carbonyl group. It is C double bond O. And we know that oxygen is more electronegative than carbon. So naturally, oxygen will try to drag the electron density from this carbon. We have discussed this before in our inductive effect video. But there we have dealt with the sigma electrons. Naturally, this electronegative oxygen atom will drag the electron density from the sigma bond as well as from the pi bond. Say this is the pi bond here. This electron density of this pi bond will be dragged towards this electronegative oxygen atom. This oxygen have two lone pairs over here already. Now this is withdrawing this bond upon itself. So what happens? Now there are three lone pair over the oxygen atom. So the formal charge of oxygen atom here will be a negative, and of that carbon will be a positive. As oxygen have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 electrons in its valence cell, and carbon has 3 electrons in its valence cell. So carbon usually have 4 electrons in valence cell. So here it is 1 electron less, that's why it's a 1 positive, and here oxygen contains 6 electrons in its valence cell, but here there is 1 electron in excess, that's why there is an additional negative charge due to the additional electron. So this phenomenon is actually associated with the pi electronic displacement. Rather, we should say permanent displacement of pi electron pairs of a double or triple bond in an unsaturated system due to the electronegativity difference between two atoms. So this is a permanent displacement. We have discussed in our very first video that mesomeric effect is among one of the permanent effects. So this is the concept of mesomeric effect. It's a permanent displacement of pi electron pairs of a double or triple bond in an unsaturated system in general due to the electronegativity difference between two atoms. In the inductive effect, we have discussed about the sigma electronic transmission in a covalent bond. And here, we are discussing about the pi electronic transmissions. Not only the pi electronic transmissions, it's a permanent displacement of pi electron pairs of a double or triple bond. So this is the concept of mesomeric effect. This is a simple example through which we can get an idea of mesomeric effect. So if we try to define the mesomeric effect, so what would be the definition? This mesomeric effect means electron redistribution that occurs only in unsaturated, mainly conjugated system via their pi orbitals. So this is the definition of mesomeric effect. Mesomeric effect means electron redistribution that occurs only in unsaturated, mainly in conjugated system via their pi orbitals. Now let's talk about the conjugated system. This is the molecule. Now say this pi electron pair will go to there, is moving there. Naturally this bond will move over the oxygen. So what does it result? This, now this electron, this pi electron pair will try to compensate the electron deficiency over this positively charged carbon atom. Why this pi electronic pair moves here? Because due to the presence of this electronegative oxygen atom, there is already a polarity has been created between C and O, as we have seen earlier here. So in order to compensate the deficiency of electron density over this carbonyl carbon center, this pi electron pair moves here. And now in order to compensate the electron deficiency over this positively charged carbon center, this pi electron pair will move here. This will be the structure. So this is structure 1, this is structure 2, and this is structure 3. So basically what we notice here, that there is an alternate double bond in this system over here, alternating double bond. So this type of system containing alternating double bond within it is considered as a conjugated system. So in this type of system mainly, which is a conjugated system, the mesomeric effect is considered. Now what is the difference between mesomeric effect and resonance? Here basically we have drawn the canonical structure of this molecule, what we always do in the resonance, but in this case we are mainly considering the permanent displacement of pi electron pairs in the individual structure of the molecule. But in the case of resonance, we actually deal with the delocalization of pi electrons within the whole system up to which the resonance is possible, or the criteria of the resonance are followed. So this is the basic difference between the mesomeric effect and resonance. In resonance, we consider the structure of a resonance hybrid which actually exists in the reality, but in mesomeric effect, we are considering the pi electronic displacement, which is a permanent effect in individual structural forms of the molecule. So that's why the mesomeric effect is considered. Now, let us talk about the generalization of mesomeric effect. So, say we have a system like this. This is a benzene in which one of the hydrogens is replaced by the atom Z. So now in presence of this Z atom, if the electron density in this benzene ring increases, then it is said that the Z atom or group has plus M effect. That is electron donating effect, the pi electron donating effect. And if in presence of Z, the electron density over this benzene ring decreases, then it is believed that the Z atom or group has minus M effect, or electron withdrawing effect, pi electron withdrawing effect. So let us consider some atoms or groups with plus M and minus M effects. Now let us consider some groups or atoms containing plus M effect. there is OH, OR, NH2, Cl, Br, F, I, SH, SR, NHR, NR2, etc. So here basically the groups or atoms with lone pairs over it are mainly considered, which can take part in pi electronic displacement. And now some groups or atoms with minus M effect, that will drag away the electron density, mainly the pi electron density basically, from the system. So what are they? That is aldehyde, ketone, nitro, carboxylic acid group, ester group, cyanide group, SO3H group, etc. So these are the groups or atoms with minus M effect. I have mentioned some of the examples. I will recommend you to consult any one of the standard textbooks. You will find many more examples there. We have to remember them while we will be solving various questions regarding mesomeric effect or resonance. And one thing more, while we are going to study this mesomeric effect or resonance, we have to have a clear idea about the hybridization or about the orientation of the orbitals in a molecule. So that's why I will recommend you to go through about the hybridization in your textbooks, and then you come to know about mesomeric effect or resonance. So the learning process will be easier for you if you have a primary idea about the hybridization. In this channel, I will make a video regarding the hybridization very soon. So let us consider one example in each case. So here we have chlorobenzene. This will help you to understand this topic easily. This electron pair over this chlorine is primarily residing in a sp3 hybridized orbital. But while it is taking part in mesomeric effect or conjugation or resonance, whatever, then this chlorine atom undergoes the change of its state of hybridization. It changes its hybridization from sp3 to sp2, and one of these lone pairs over here are residing in a pure orbitals. That lone pair, say this is the lone pair here, that lone pair takes part in conjugation with this benzene nucleus. In benzene, all the carbons are sp2 hybridized, we know. So this lone pair takes part in conjugation with the p orbitals of this sp2 hybridized carbon atoms. Now here also we get the same. So this is the rearrangement process. And again, if we do this, then we will get back to the initial structure. Here the electron flows from this chlorine atom to the benzene ring. So that's why this electron density over this benzene ring increases, because of this minus charge, because of this negative charge is residing in the three canonical forms. So that's why this chlorine atom here is believed to have plus M effect. But in case of nitrobenzene, what happens? Here, the nitrogen is sp2 hybridized, in which the unhybridized p orbital have taken part in conjugation with this oxygen. Now, this pi electronic density will go outside of the ring to compensate the electron deficiency over this nitrogen. And the picture will look like this. There will be no change in the formal charge of nitrogen. If we do the electron count, we will find that there is no change in formal charge. Now, in order to compensate this electron deficiency over this carbon center, this pi bond moves. Once you get the clear idea of this mesomeric effect or resonance, then it will be very easy to find out any one of the structures. You can do it yourself. Now, if we do this, we will get back to our initial structure. So, in presence of this nitro group over here, the electron density over this benzene ring is decreased as we have a positive charge within the benzene ring. But here, in case of chlorobenzene, we have a negative charge over here. But here, we have a positive charge. That's why the electron density of this benzene ring is being dragged away. So, this nitro group has minus M effect. So, one thing is very clear that we should possess a clear idea about the state of hybridization while we are doing the problems related to resonance or mesomeric effect. So, this was our today's video about mesomeric effect. If you liked it, then give it a thumbs up. And also subscribe to our channel to watch more similar topic-wise videos on chemistry. In this channel, we make videos on the different topic-wise concepts of chemistry, which will be beneficial for the 10 plus 2 level students as well as for the NEET or JEE aspirants and the undergraduate chemistry students. So, stay tuned, stay safe. Thanks for watching.